March the 10th of September here, Monday. Looking at this euro here. 1:15:30, quite an important level. Looks like this is in the crosshairs today. Not too much news over the weekend. Trump is babbling about more tariffs, but yet equities have bounced a bit. Sweden is in flux. We don't really trade SEK, so I don't really know what to do with that, except for that it's probably not a good thing that a bunch of nationalists are winning votes in liberal Scandinavia. Can't see that as good. And then, of course, Boris was flapping away, trying to kick Theresa May in the shins over the weekend with some poor metaphors about suicide bombers and whatnot. He's an idiot. Smart guy, actually, but good guy to have at a dinner party, but the last guy you want to be running a country. So, I don't really know what to do with that. Our main focus is going to be here on this euro dollar. 39 the low so far. We're trading at 44. Europe's going to probably take this through at the open. So, be ready for that. Kind of want to be core short from here. High has been 64, but you really want to be core short with a stop above 93. So even prices above 64 is a fade today, and we could easily see move up a little bit here at the open, but eventually we're going to see this thing through 30, and then through 30, we'll have to see. We'll have to look at boons and BTPs and see what's going on. But it's an important level for the euro. Alongside with that, we like euro sterling lower, just core short. From here on out, looks like soft Brexit is going to happen. And soft Brexit means eventually cable to 140 and euro sterling to 76, 75, maybe 70. So, core short euro sterling until further notice. This is directional trade for us that we like. Aussie punished just doesn't go up well, right? 71 the figure, the low. Finally got through that sort of 71.40 zone on Friday with trade news and threats and whatever. Amazing how directional that's been. I don't know what to do with it at 71 the figure, and if you are short, we actually are not short, you might want to start thinking about making this a tradable short versus a directional short. Dollar rand, we did not get given at 03, which was a shame on Friday, but we still think there's a possibility, not a high one, that we fill in this sort of 96 to 06 area here, and so we're patiently waiting on the bid in dollar rand. And we're not really sure where we're going to have to exercise longs again by buying high ones, but somewhere. Not sure on this. We're patiently waiting, but I have the distinct feeling that these bids down here that we have are going to get very, very lonely and are just never going to get filled. So the same theme is in play. Dollar rand should go higher. Look a bit wobbly. Obviously, they're in recession. They have no leadership. There's a drought. the government's trying to steal land. Not a lot of good things are happening in that country currently. So I don't really see any reason to buy the currency. And the only reason it goes up is to stop out people, specs like us, who are shorted. So eventually the dollars are long, they're going to win. And so we're square at the moment, but we're still looking in the same direction. Dollar CAD was a bit tricky on Friday, up to 90, down to 30, pretty bad numbers on the employment side. Not super clear what to do with this. So we're going to stand down for now. We're short a bit of Euro CAD there Friday, which paid kind of a Euro dollar driven idea, but not super sure there. Euro yen should continue lower. What was Friday's low? Friday's low was figure. Now we're at 07. This is probably going to coincide with 30 in euro. So, of course, short euro yen also looks the way. Alright, I will leave you guys with that. Basically, core short euro sterling, euro dollar, and to a lesser extent euro yen, but euro yen also looks like a possible horse today. We'll see what happens in an hour's time when London gets in 2 hours' time when the sort of systems get turned on, but we like this euro.